Hello, my name is Klaus Eckelt and I'm a PhD student and doctoral researcher at the Johannes Kepler University in Linz in Austria. I'm presenting Kokiri today, a visual analytics approach to compare and characterize cohorts. With a random forest, we try to classify the cohorts based on user-selected data and rank attributes by their importance to distinguish between cohorts. We show how well patients were matched to the cohorts and the probabilities of the patients to belong to the individual classes, once in a detailed list, and once by projecting them to a scatterplot for overview. This way, we give an overview over the cohort separability, what makes them separable, and how homogeneous the cohorts are with respect to the data. The idea for Kokiri grew out of Coral, an application for creating and characterizing cohorts. In Coral, we can easily define cohorts based on genomic or metadata, but comparison is limited to one or two attributes. We have already integrated Tordino in Coral, where cohorts can be statistically compared based on user-defined attributes. But the cohorts are compared by each attribute individually, so their overall separability cannot be judged, and also combinatorial effects of multiple attributes are not considered. We have also seen this limitation in many other works, and have therefore created Kokiri to compare cohorts by the high-dimensional data and find the driving differences between them. We have integrated Kokiri in Coral to make use of its cohort creation and characterization functionalities, and I will next explain Kokiri based on a use case we have also described in our paper. For that, I'm going to start from a previous session in Coral in which the user created cohorts of non-small cell lung cancer patients of different race and gender. A recent study has shown differences in the KRAS mutation frequency between these cohorts, and by using Kokiri, we want to investigate whether there are any further mutational differences. We start by selecting the six cohorts and select the characterize operation which integrates Kokiri and Coral. As the cohorts are created by splitting the data into distinct subsets, the overlap view only shows a short note that the cohorts do not overlap. I will show an example with overlapping cohorts later in my talk. In the next step, we can compare the cohorts by their metadata or the genetic mutation frequency. By default, the comparison only considers attributes that were not used to create the cohorts. We compare the cohorts by mutation frequency, which starts training a random forest model to classify the cohorts based on the high-dimensional data. We gradually increase the number of decision trees in the forest and show intermediate results to give users early feedback on cohort separability and important attributes. The interface of Kokiri is divided into four sections, and the cohorts are represented by color throughout all sections. At the top right, a stacked bar chart shows how the patients are matched with cohorts. For the six lung cancer cohorts, we can see that most items are correctly assigned to the white female and male cohorts, which are also the two largest cohorts. However, also large portions of patients from the other cohorts are assigned to these two. In the table on the left, we rank attributes by their importance in the random forest model. The first results show that the genes TP53, EGFR, SDK11, KRAS, and FGFR4 are the most different between the six cohorts. The column on the right shows the distribution of the attribute for each cohort. These are all categorical data and we therefore use a bar chart. For gene mutations, the bar chart shows for each cohort how many patients have an amino acid mutation for that specific gene. For EGFR mutations, we can see differences between the gender, but there's also a huge difference between the two Asian patient cohorts and the others. Noticeable is also the distribution of FGFR4 mutations, where the bars are hardly visible. We further investigate the distribution of FGFR4 mutations in Coral's view operation. There, we can see that there is indeed little difference in the number of mutations, but the gene is sequenced much less frequently for the two black cohorts. This could point to possible issues in the data, and we will look into that later in my talk. Next, we further analyze the trained classifier with the characterization view in Kokiri. The table on the left lists all patients, the cohorts they belong to, and by which probability they belong to that cohort according to the classifier. We also have the highest probability as a separate column to quickly judge whether the model was sure or unsure about this item. On the right side, these probabilities are summarized in an embedding scatterplot. We project the probabilities to two dimensions with supervised UMAP. The scatterplot shows one point for every patient, colored by the cohort they belong to. And in the background, we plot a heat map that shows the cohort with the highest prediction probability with that cohort's color. The heat map's opacity decreases with the classifier's confidence, so when the probability of the predicted cohort has little difference to the others. The scatter plot shows a distinct cluster for each of the six cohorts, but also many smaller clusters as well as single items. By hovering over one of the smaller clusters, we see that the probability for the assignment to the Asian female cohort was just 25.7%. We select the items in this cluster, which also selects them in the item ranking, where we can see probabilities for all other cohorts. Even though the items in this cluster originate from the different cohorts, the prediction probabilities are very similar, suggesting that the data is similar as well. This could be a point in the analysis where the user leaves Kokiri and defines new cohorts based on the findings or investigates individual items in more detail. But in the remaining time of my talk, I want to look into another finding we had, which is that FGFR4 is sequenced much less frequently for black patients than for the other cohorts. With Kokiri, I want to compare the black patient cohort with the overall lung cancer cohort to see if there are any other differences there. The overlap visualization now shows that one cohort is a subset of the other, the difference in size and the overlap size. In the attribute importance table, FGFR4 is now ranked the highest to differentiate the cohorts, and BRCA1 shows a similar pattern in mutation frequency. It is also sequenced less frequently, with about 50% of the data being unknown for black patients, while it is just 25% for the overall lung cancer cohort. One reason for this may be the huge differences in how comprehensively genomics data are collected at the different sites where patients are treated. The prediction table at the bottom now only shows that items belong to multiple cohorts. As a next step, we would like to combine Kokiri with low-dimensional embeddings of the high-dimensional data. On Friday, I will present a work on the exploration of structured data in low-dimensional embeddings. There, we already have a ranked list of attributes to highlight differences between groups in the embedding, but the attributes are considered individually and not in combination. That is, however, only one part, and I hope to see you on Friday where I can go into more detail. With this teaser, I would like to end my presentation and invite you to check out the paper, code, and application via the QR code and link on the last slide. I look forward to answer your questions and discuss ideas online or at the conference in the upcoming days. Thank you.